हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आहूजा क्लासेस स्मार्टनेस इन एजुकेशन। हेयर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द यूक्लिड्स डिवीजन लेमा एंड यूक्लिड्स डिवीजन एल्गोरिदम ऑफ रियल नंबर्स कॉन्सेप्ट। लेट अस फर्स्ट सी द यूक्लिड्स डिवीजन लेमा। लेमा इज लाइक अ थ्योरम। अकॉर्डिंग टू यूक्लिड्स डिवीजन लेमा, actually this division lemma is basically the basic division theorem. If we have suppose two positive integers, they are a and b, then there exist unique integers q and r which satisfies the condition a equals to bq plus r. It can be compared with the division algorithm or the division theorem that dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So B is the divisor, Q is the quotient, and R is the remainder. And remainder is always less than the divisor, but it can be greater than 0 or equal to 0. And the basis of the Euclid's division algorithm is the Euclid's division lemma. Let us see the determination of HCF, that means highest common factor or greatest common integer, using Euclid's division algorithm. HCF or highest common factor or greatest common integer is that largest number which exactly divides two or more positive integers. And here the meaning of exactly division is that on dividing the given numbers or the given integers a and b, the remainder we will get will be 0. So highest common factor is that largest number. If we divide the given numbers by that highest common factor, the remainder will be 0. So to calculate the highest common factor of two positive integers a and b, we use the Euclid's division algorithm. Let us see it by some examples. See, the first question says we have to use Euclid's division algorithm to find the HCF of 4052 and 12576. In this problem, we have to find the highest common factor of these two integers. According to Euclid's algorithm, we need to write this by a step-by-step process. In earlier classes, we have learned to find the HCF by long division method, but here we will learn to find the HCF by using Euclid's division algorithm. So that long division process should be written in a systematic form in the Euclid's division algorithm. Let us first review the long division method, and we will solve simultaneously by using the Euclid's division algorithm. We have to divide 12576 by 4052. This is the step 1. By dividing this number by 4052, we get the quotient as 3, and we get the result of this value. That is 12,156. So remainder is 420. This is the first step of Euclid's division algorithm. So at first step, since 12,576 is greater than 4,052, so by Euclid's division algorithm, we can write 12,576 equals to, first of all, we have to write, we have Euclid division lemma is A equals to BQ plus R, where A is the dividend. So 12,576 is the dividend and 4,052 is our divisor. Quotient is 3 and remainder is 420. Now let's move to the second stage. Now we will make 420 as the divisor and 4,052 as dividend. So we get, now this will be our step 2. In this step, 4,052 is greater than 420. So again, by Euclid's division algorithm, that means A equals to BQ plus R, we get 4,052 equals to, this will be divided it 9 times. So we get 3780, and the remainder will be equal to 272. Now, so in the second stage, we have divisor as 420, quotient is 9, and the remainder is 272. So still we are getting the remainder, but for HCF we need that highest number which exactly divides the given numbers. So we will have to move to step 3. So we will make the remainder, that means 272 as divisor and 420 as quotient, 420 as dividend. So we get only in one time, that will be, and the remainder will be 148. So in stage 3, we have 420 greater than 272. So by Euclid's division algorithm, that means A equals to BQ plus R, we can write 420 as 272 into 1 plus remainder is 148. Still we are getting the remainder, so we will have to move to step 4. So here 148 I am writing here 148 as the remainder, and this is 272. Again, this will be divided only one time, so we get the remainder is 124. So in stage 4, we can write in the similar process, we can write 272 as 148 into 1 plus 124. Again, we have got the remainder, so we have to move again. I am writing here just because of the lack of space, 124, and this is 148. So this will be divided only one time again, so we get the remainder as 24. So at stage 5 or step 5, we have got 148 equals to 124 into 1 plus 24. Still we are getting the remainder. We have to move till we do not get the remainder as 0. So in this case, remainder is 24. This will be made as the divisor, and 124 will be our dividend. So in 5 times we get 120 and remainder is 4. So stage 6 will be 124 equals to 24 into 5 plus 4 is the remainder. Still we are getting the remainder as 4. So now we need one more step, that will be step 7. Here 4 is the remainder and 24 is the dividend, so we get in 6 times. Yeah, so here we have got the remainder as 0. So our process will be finished over here. Here we have got 24 is equals to 4 into 6 plus 0. So this is the last step where we have got the remainder as 0. So the highest common factor of 4052 and 12576 is 4. That means the last divisor in the Euclid's division lemma is called the HCF of the given numbers. Or in the long division process, the last stage divisor is the highest common factor of the given integers. So we can write HCF of 4052 and 12576 is equals to 4, and that is our answer. Let us see a practical application of HCF by using a real-time problem. Let us see, a sweet seller has 420 kaju barfis and 130 badam barfis. She wants to stack them, means she wants to arrange in a particular column, vertical columns, in such a way that each stack or each vertical column has the same number of barfis, and they take up the least area of the tray. So the question refers to the situation in which we have to occupy minimum area of the tray by placing burpees in such a manner that they have equal number as well as it should be maximum. It should have be the highest number of burpees in each stack, and that in each stack the number of burpees should be same. So least area will be obtained only when if the maximum number of burpees are arranged in each stack, and it is given that we have to place the same number of burpees, so we need maximum as well as equal number of burpees in each stack. So we have to find the highest common number of burpees in each stack. So we need to find the HCF of kaju burpees and badam burpees. That means we need to find the highest common factor of 130 and 420. So we will place the number of burpees in that particular manner in which each stack has equal number as well as highest number of burpees. So the process can also be done by trial and error, but it will take a very long time. So we will use the concept of highest common factor. By finding highest common factor of 420 and 130 equal number of burpees can be placed in each stack. So we have to find the HCF by Euclid's division lemma. So let us solve as well as place the values according to the long division method in the Euclid's division lemma. This will be divisible 3 times and we will get 390 in the first stage. So the remainder will be 30. So at stage first, here we have 420 greater than 130, and Euclid's division lemma is A equals to BQ plus R, where the value of R is less than B but greater than or equal to 0. So we can write 420 equals to 130 into 3 plus 30 is the remainder. Now in step second, we have 130 greater than 30, so it can be written as 130 equals to 30 into 4 times. In 4 times we get 120, so remainder will be 10. So still we have not got the remainder as 0, so we have to move up to step 3. Now 10 will be the divisor and 30 will be the dividend. So in 3 times we get 30, and here we have got the remainder as 0. So we have got actually the highest number of burpees that must be placed in each stack of the tray. So here 30 is greater than 10, we can write 10 into 3 plus 0. So 10 is the exactly highest number of burpees that must be placed in each stack so that the tray must occupy the least space. So we can write the answer as SCF of 420 and 130 equals to 10. Therefore, the sweet seller can make a stack of 10 for both kinds of burpees. So here we have learned the concept of highest common factor by using the Euclid's division algorithm. In the next lecture, we will solve some more problems based upon the concept of highest common factor. Thank you. For more educational videos, like and share and subscribe the Ahuja classes on YouTube. Thank you.